Hello and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video I'll be sharing some tips that you should be taking care of, like whenever you are starting your literature review for your PhD or for the masters, specifically for PhD, because in PhD students usually have to find their problems themselves. And I've made some separate videos that how to start a literature review and all these things, but in this video I'll be sharing some specific to the point tips that you should take care of whenever you are starting your literature review. So let's move on to the tips. Firstly, you need to make sure that your literature review, or like whenever you are writing your literature review is not just summarizing all the previous works. It's like just not summary of existing literature. It should be useful, it should be problem oriented, and it should be you can say state of the art. Like, you should not just be summarizing all the previous works and saying that this is your literature review. Your literature review is basically the backbone of your PhD. It's just like garbage in, garbage out. So GIGO, that's a formula that I usually uses in my terminologies, that if you are inputting something as garbage, the output will be garbage. So make sure you do a good literature review. But the tips that will be helpful for you during your literature review are, like, first of all, you should be picking a generalized topic. You can discuss this topic with your supervisor, that you are interested to work in this specific XYZ area, and afterwards you will be finalizing the research problem. So do not pick the research problem randomly, that okay, I'll solve, let's say, the security issues of smart grid, or and you do not pick any random research problem just by getting motivated with some fancy words. Pick a major domain, a generalized topic, or you can say a broad topic first, and then you can narrow down these things step by step. So first tip is, not start right out, start from, you can say, basic research problem. Pick a generalized topic first. The second thing is, you can narrow down the field into or you can say break down these things, the major domain or major topic that you have selected, into 3 to 4 subdomains. For example, if you have picked one topic of you can say you want to work in the security, or you can say cyber security of smart grid, then you can break it down to 3 or 4 fields, that what are the possible options for working in the domain of cyber security of smart grid. So first of all, making a generalized topic, and then you can break it down to 3 or 4 domains, so that you can do a literature review for each domain, and then you can link all these things. This can even give you possibility that in the future of in your PhD degree, or even after your PhD degree, you can work over these topics and merge these topics. So you will, instead of just working in one line, you will have 3 to 4 topics, and you had done literature review for these topics, and you can merge these topics in future as well. So after 3 to 4 domains, you can say once we have finalized these 3 to 4 domains, find the list of references for all these domains. For example, like, you can say one specific mechanism used a specific technique or specific method to solve this problem, the second for the second domain as well, for the third domain as well. So third tip would be, find all the references of these topics. You can make Excel sheets, you can make you can manage these references using Mendeley, up to you. That's totally up to you. But find all the state of the art references, so you do not miss any, not even a single reference from any of the subdomain. You can differentiate between technical references and the survey references as well. For example, these are the number of references there are in surveys in that specific field, and these are the references that are technical references. So make sure to pick all the references when you for all the specific domains that you have decided. The fourth thing is, now you have all the references for the fields that you have pre-decided, and now you should be studying these references. But let's say you have gathered like more than 200 or 300 references, you cannot study them all. You need to pick some of the best ones. So pick some best references and then start studying them. Let's say from the 4 fields that you have decided, you can pick one field that, okay, I'll be working over this specific domain first, and you should be studying all the references, all the selected references for, let's say, 20 references or 30 references, 20 articles, 30 articles from that field. And then what I would recommend within that, I would recommend that you should be first reading some survey articles that will give you a basic idea, or I can say a basic insight that what exactly that field demands, and then you can move on to the technical references. And whenever you are studying some references, think about the questions that have not been addressed. For example, like you are studying some technical article or some survey article, and you should be thinking about that, okay, this has discussed a specific problem for a specific thing, and it can also be addressed in some other manner, or it can be modify this problem and solve it in a better way. So whenever you are studying the references, try to make notes, as much notes as you can, and then think about some brainstorming. For example, like whenever you study one paper, and then think about all the work that you have studied in that paper for like 5 to 10 minutes or 20 minutes, recall everything in your brain, and you might end up finding some idea, or you can say you might end up finding some next research problem that you will be solving in your PhD. So these are the few tips that I would say that I would highly recommend everyone whenever they are going to start their literature review. And that's all for today's video. If you want me to discuss any specific topic or any specific thing, you can write down in the comment section. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye bye.